I want to ask you about the access and getting so close to this family, particularly the young girl who was a teenager. And you caught some very personal moments for her, didn't you?
Yeah, I mean, making a documentary film, especially when you're filming with a subject who is a 16-year-old girl who's always very opinionated. It's not entirely an easy job to do. But like I said, we spent 3 years filming with this one particular family. I would really embed my crew into their life. First of all, we open up ourselves. We let them know who we are, where we're from, why we're doing this film. I told the couple when we first met, I am trying to, you know, sort of give a voice to the migrant workers, to tell a story of your own. So there's something for them in it as well. And they understand that, and I think they appreciated it. So we always kept a very close relationship with the family. Gradually, when we spent more time with them, they really took us in as part of the family. I would ask my crew to just hang out with them, even if we're not filming. Like, we would wait till midnight when they finish their work. We just lie on a pile of jeans that are still warm to get a shot from the family.
Well, and from that, over the 3 years, you got to see a family that was falling apart in some ways. I don't know if you expected to see that, but the teenage girl has serious problems with her parents. They haven't been part of her life, and she lets you know in the film.
Yeah. I mean, we never expected the sort of outburst, the dissemination of the family, but I know that for a migrant family in which the parents and the children may often get estranged with each other because just they don't spend that much time together over the years. So we sort of see this pattern, but nobody could really predict what's going to happen in this one particular family. And during the filming, in the second year of the filming, while we just got back to their village home after all this ordeal at the train station and on the road,
right,
we see this family kind of had a total outburst of the conflict between two generations, while the daughter was always felt neglected by the parents, and the parents always are frustrated, and they feel that they have sacrificed everything for their children's benefit, but they just could not. I don't know, there's something not working in this family. And then the daughter and the father got into this.
Yes, I wanted to ask you, this is a remarkable scene, and I don't want to give it away because people should see it, but it's a scene where there's an argument that turns into a fight between the father and the daughter. Now, you knew these people at this point. You were pretty close to them. This must have been hard to watch. Were you tempted to put down the camera at some point? What happens at a moment like
that? I mean, to me, it's heartbreaking to see this. Like I said, we spent so much time together up to that point, and they took us in as part of their family, and so did we. So it was really hard to see. It's like seeing your own family fight each other, while you know that none of them are wrong. It's nobody's fault,
right.
Really. The parent left to just try to make money so that the children can go to school, have a better life, and you can't really blame a 16-year-old growing up all by herself and get frustrated.
Mm-hmm.
When it happened, I was in another room. I was changing a light bulb, and I heard the yelling. I come over. My first instinct was, I was going to go in and stop this, but my cameraman and my soundman was in the doorway, so they blocked me for a moment. And, you know, there's this a very difficult argument that's going on in my head, as on one side the ethical the ethics of make documentary filmmaking.
The ethics, yeah.
The ethics versus the emotional attachment that I had toward this family. It was really a hard time. Still, I didn't know if I did the right choice or did the wrong choice, but it just happened as it did, and my cameraman, I have to thank to him that he didn't stop the camera while I was battling with myself. Mm-hmm. But afterwards, I still went in the frame and separated the daughter and the father when they tried to get physical, like fight again.
Did you just finally? Have you kept up with them? Have they seen the film?
Well, yeah, we always kept in contact mm-hmm. with the family. The father and the mother saw the film when we first had a chance to show it in Guangzhou, where they work. The mother, after watching it, told us that she only said that she still couldn't understand why her daughter hates her so much while they sacrificed everything for her. Mm-hmm. And the father didn't say much. He just told me that he's very sad watching it, and I can totally understand that. Qing never saw the film.
Qing, the daughter. Yeah.
Yeah, Qing, the daughter. She never saw the film. I asked her if she wants to see it. She says, "I don't want to make myself sad again." But now, she's studying in Beijing. A few friends.
She is.
Yes, she's 20 years of age now. After. You know, all the filming, and she migrated a little bit to find work in other cities in China, and then we managed to help her to find one vocational school in Beijing, and some friends are helping her to try to get a diploma, and really, I think she grown up quite a lot, and she now realized that only through education she would land a decent job and hopefully make her own independence in the cities.
Okay, Lixin Fan, thanks again.
Thank you.